Now we are going to take up dipole-dipole interaction or dipole-dipole forces. First of all, what type of molecules will have dipole-dipole interaction? Answer is polar molecules. What type polar molecule means that those molecules which have difference in their electronegativity. And when there is difference in electronegativity, there is a permanent dipole moment. So the force of attraction between polar molecules is called dipole-dipole attraction or dipole-dipole attractive forces. Ends of the dipole possess partial charges, and these partial charges we represent by delta. Delta positive will represent positive charge, delta negative will represent negative charge. Delta means that there is a small charge. Partial charges are always less than unit electronic charge. What is unit electronic charge? This is charge on the electron. Charge on the electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. So these partial charges are less than this charge. This charge will be developed when there is a complete transfer of electron. Here only electrons are attracted towards the more electronegative atom, so it has got partially negative charge. And other atom which is less electronegative has partially positive charge. So the polar molecules interact with neighboring molecules. This interaction is comparatively stronger than London forces but weaker than ion-ion interaction because only partial charges are involved. In ion-ion interaction, ionic bond is formed and they are strong electrostatic force of attraction. In non-polar molecules, we have London forces or van der Waals forces of attraction which are quite weak. So, and these dipole-dipole interaction are in between them, between non-polar molecules and highly polar ions where there is strong electrostatic force of attraction. The attractive forces decrease with the increase in distance between the dipole. That is natural that if the distance between the dipoles is more, the attractive forces will be less. And if the distance between attractive forces or oppositely charged delta positive and delta negative dipoles, if distance is less, attractive forces will be more. And interaction energy is inversely proportional to the distance between the polar molecules. Dipole-dipole interaction energy between stationary polar molecules. Stationary means which are not moving. In solids, molecules are not moving. It is proportional to 1 over r cube. But in rotating polar molecules, if polar molecules are in gaseous form and they can move easily, then it is proportional to 1 over r raised to the power 6, where r is distance between the polar molecules. Besides this, dipole-dipole interaction, polar molecules can also interact by London forces. Means London forces is the additional force which exists between polar molecules along with dipole-dipole interaction. This is the diagram which is showing dipole-dipole attraction. HCl, hydrogen is less electronegative, it acquires delta positive charge. Chlorine is more electron negative, it has got delta negative charge. So electron density is more on chlorine and less on hydrogen, therefore this dipole has been created. This dipole is a permanent dipole. So we have got HCl molecule and another HCl molecule. Cl negative of one of the HCl molecule attracts H positive of the other molecule of HCl, and the force of attraction between them is called dipole-dipole attraction, and it is stronger than van der Waals force of attraction because of polarity. The cumulative effect is the total intermolecular force of attraction in polar molecules will increase due to dipole-dipole attraction along with the intermolecular force of attraction. Now we are taking dipoles, induced dipole forces. Now what molecule will show dipole induced dipole forces? Here one molecule is polar, whereas other molecule is non-polar. For example, iodine. Iodine is a non-polar molecule, whereas water is a polar molecule. So the attraction between iodine and water will involve dipole induced dipole forces. This type of attractive forces operated between polar molecules. Example I have just now given you, water molecule. And why water molecule is polar? Because it has permanent dipole. Why it has permanent dipole? Because there is a difference in electronegativity of hydrogen and oxygen. And iodine example I have given you of non-polar molecule which does not have dipole moment and it does not have permanent dipole. So permanent dipole of polar molecules, that water induces dipole on electrically neutral molecule like iodine by deforming its electronic cloud. Thus the induced dipole is developed in the non-polar molecule, that is iodine. In this case also interaction energy is proportional to 1 over r raised to the power 6, where r is distance between the molecules. That is, greater the distance between the molecules, lesser will be interactive forces of attraction. Induced dipole moment depends upon the dipole moment of the permanent molecule. Means highly polar molecule like water can induce more dipole moment in non-polar molecule like iodine. And the polarizability of electrically neutral molecule. Now polarizability of the neutral molecule depends upon its size. For example, iodine is bigger in size, so it is easily polarizable. Xenon gas is bigger in size, it is easily polarizable. So larger electronegative atoms are easily polarizable, so they will have induced dipole very easily with the help of polar molecules. In this case also, cumulative effect of dispersion forces, dipole induced dipole attraction both exist. Here we are showing you with the help of diagram. In AB there is a permanent dipole, so it is a polar molecule. Example can be HCl. Non-polar molecule we can take iodine, or any other non-polar molecule we can take hydrogen. Now polar molecule will induce dipole in a non-polar molecule. So the negative end of B will induce positive end close by, positive charge to the near end, and the other end will become negatively charged. So this diagram shows how a permanent polar molecule, a polar molecule having permanent dipole moment, can induce a polarity or induce dipole in a non-polar molecule. Next topic we are taking is thermal energy. Thermal energy is the energy of body arising from the motion of its atoms or molecules. Now molecules are not in state of rest except in solid state. In liquid state, in gaseous state, molecules are in continuous random motion. And because they are in continuous random motion, therefore they possess energy. And this energy can be called as thermal energy. It is directly proportional to temperature of substance. Means if temperature is higher, then thermal energy will be more. If temperature is lower, thermal energy will be less. It is the measure of average kinetic energy of the particles of the matter and is thus responsible for movement of particles. Now we have studied that kinetic energy is directly proportional to absolute temperature. So if temperature is high, molecules will move with higher velocity, that is will have higher kinetic energy. And this movement of particles is also called thermal motion. Intramolecular forces versus thermal interaction. We have already studied that intramolecular forces tend to keep the molecules together, but thermal energy of molecules will try to keep them apart. So there is a struggle between the two, and that will decide the state of matter at a particular temperature. For example, at 0 degree centigrade, thermal motion of molecules is very less in case of water, so it exists as solid. Above 0 degree centigrade, thermal motion of molecule increases, it will exist as liquid. And above 100 degree centigrade, thermal motion increases much more and it changes to gaseous state. It means the physical state of the substance is decided with the help of intramolecular forces and thermal energy. Three states of matter are result of balance between intramolecular forces and thermal energy of the molecules. When the molecule interactions are very weak, molecules do not cling together to make liquid or solid unless and until thermal energy is reduced by lowering temperature. For example, gas molecules are far away from each other. Liquid molecules are also away from each other. Gases, some of them do not liquefy on compression only. Although molecules come very close to each other and intramolecular forces of attraction operates between them to the maximum extent. However, the thermal energy of interactive forces also operate to maximum extent. But when thermal energy of molecule can be reduced with the help of lowering temperature, then only we can liquefy the gas. Means that while lowering the temperature, we are reducing their thermal motion or thermal energy and increasing the intermolecular force of attraction. That is the reason that the gases can be liquefied only at low temperature, and they also require high pressure for liquefaction. This diagram shows how gas can be changed into liquid by increasing temperature, and liquid can be changed into solid. Gases can be changed into liquid by lowering down the temperature and applying high pressure. Similarly, liquid can be changed into solid by lowering down the temperature, and sometimes pressure is also required to change them into solid. For example, carbon dioxide can be solidified by applying high pressure. So, predominance from gases to liquid and liquid to solid, intramolecular force of attraction goes on increasing, whereas thermal motion goes on decreasing. On the other hand, if we heat solid, it will change to liquid, and if we heat liquid, it will change into gases. It means that thermal motion of molecules keeps on increasing when we move from solid to liquid and liquid to gases, but intermolecular force of attraction goes on decreasing. Predominance of thermal energy and molecular interaction of a substance in three states of matter are depicted in this diagram which I have discussed just now.